guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Deirdre Matiwane, but you can call me Tammy, and you can follow me on Instagram at Life of a Tammy, and you can follow me on Facebook as Tammy Matiwane. Guys, excuse my voice, I have flu, and geyo, it is bad. I'm even isolating because I don't know if it's COVID or what, but anyway, I did test and I'm still waiting for my results. Otherwise, I'm in isolation. Yeah, so today's story time is about how my friend left me and my other friend stranded, guys. Yo, so please don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel and keep on watching. Enjoy. So guys, what had happened was, it was my friend's birthday. So we are three friends. It's me and what am I gonna name her? Cindy and Michelle. Yeah, it's me, Cindy, and Michelle, and it's Cindy's birthday. So Michelle and Cindy didn't tell me that like they're gonna do something for the day. So we at varsity, so we in class and we go home. I go home to my place and they leave also. So now at night, I think it was past 8 past 9, but it was late already and I was already in my PJs. So so it's past 9 and Michelle calls me or texts me back. Babes, we at this place called the Lighthouse in Summer Strand. We stay in PEK. It's our first year at varsity. So she's like, we're at this place called Lighthouse in Summer Strand. Can you please Uber here? It's me and Cindy. We celebrating Cindy's birthday. So can you please come? And I'm like, okay, no problem. And I request an Uber. I go. And okay, when I get there, okay, they're already points in front of me, so they've been drinking. So I get there and Michelle is like, yeah, to the bartender, like she orders a couple of shots because she needs me to get drunk so that we can be on the same page now. Like I take shots, hey, like it's nice, come on, you're like boom. It's nice. We drink, man. Come on, like it's nice. It's a chill place. The music is nice. We're playing pool. Like it's a nice vibe. And it's during the week. Hey, it's nice. And when you get to the lighthouse, you need to go through the boardwalk. And it's quite big. So, me going to boardwalk, like I used to go there during the day. And I never went to the back of it to see the lighthouse. Because most of the time, I travel with my grandparents. So, you don't really go to places like the lighthouse with your grandparents. So, I'm like, okay. I'm new here, so why not? Oh, boom, 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 boom. It's nice. We get drunk. We meet guys. So, the guys come. They join us. They buy alcohol. I can't say. Mandy, like it's nice, we are drinking, and now they're trying to entertain us. And it's where I knew, oh, my friend, oh, Michelle, she is from PE, but me and Cindy, we're not from PE. Like, I used to come to PE for holidays, but it doesn't count. And like, Cindy, she's not from here, it's her first time coming for like to study. So, we're exploring the town now. The city or whatever you want to call PE. So the guys, they notice that, okay, like we are not from here, and the way we're talking, like I feel like Michelle is like, no, they're my friends, but they're not from here. And they're like, okay, guys, do you smoke Habli? And she's like, yeah, smoke Habli. And I'm like, yo, Michelle, you're too drunk and we don't know these guys. Now I have that small town attitude of mine being scared. And like, we're uncomfortable, me and Sunday now. But Michelle, yo, she's bubbly. Yo. She's very bubbly. And the guys are like, okay, we have Habli at our place. So can you please come with us to our place? We're going to relax there. And by the way, the lighthouse closes at 12. So you obviously need to go. And I'm like, no, we're going to finance. We are not going to sit here or go to your place. Yo. And Cindy agrees. She's like, my friend, I was never at finance, but I'm going to go with you to finance. And Michelle is like, no, I'm not going to finance. Don't. I'm going with the guys. And I'm like, I'm not going with guys that I don't know that I met 2 minutes ago. Where do they stay? Where? Summer Strand. So I guess. So me and Michelle, we start like not really arguing, but disagreeing. And Cindy is quiet because she's a quiet person. She's sitting there. She's like, guys, I just want to go home and I'm hungry. And I'm like, yeah, I'm also hungry. Uba, Michelle, Makambe. She just left us. We said to her, like, okay, Michelle is going now. Like, she walked out the door. 2 minutes later, when we go check for her, Tololo, Michelle. Like, bo. And now we are stranded. We're like, which way did we come in? Because I don't know. And we tell ourselves, bah, okay, now we need to go. But the only thing we need to look for is the entrance at the boardwalk. Like the entrance when you come inside the boardwalk. When we are there, we'll know we're safe. And Gengoku, I know next to the boardwalk, there's a garage. We can just stand at the garage and request or something, but we need to get to the main road, the beachfront. Hey, I know, we try to go, we try to find the entrance, but Dololo entrance. And I tell Sindiba, babes, if we move further, we're going to get lost. And we might get attacked and raped because now it's dark. And we're moving in circles. And finally, we spot the exit, which is like the entrance to the boardwalk. So now we're like, "Kyo!" As we're about to give up, we spot the exit and then we go. And we're on the beachfront, like now the main road. I'm like, okay, let's go to the garage next to the boardwalk. I can we go. Like, we are frustrated now. We are frustrated now. And because we don't know where Michelle is. And we don't know the way. Like, home or what to do. And, like, I'm asking Cindy, where is the accommodation? No, it's in Newton Park. Where in Newton Park? Which number? Just so that we can Uber. I stand with Cindy. Drunkest. And I'm like, okay. We sit. And this car comes with its colored guys. It's two guys and two girls. So this guy's like, Aibo, why are you sitting at the garage? What's wrong? Like the lady asked. And we explained, like, yo, onze vriend het ons nergens gelos. And no, ons weet nie waar, just saying, da, 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 da. We're trying to explain, but yeah, we are stranded now. What, da, da, da. Yo, and the lady starts crying, telling us about how her cousin was raped at the boardwalk. It's on a stress levels. And now we are looking at her as like we are shocked. We are scared. We are shocked. We are worried. The lady is crying. She's not helping us. She's telling us her problems. And her boyfriend here is like, if you need anything, just call me. Just call me any time of the day. Yo! He's giving us his number. And I'm like, we are pleader because if you wanted to help us, you could have done something now. Now, don't tell us to call you at dead of night. You're bleeder. God, we are stranded. Johnny, Conjohnny, bro. Here's your girlfriend sobbing next to you about her cousin. And when are you busy bleeding us? Metal. Hey, and like the lady tells us what to do. And I'm like, aye, babes, I'm hungry. So thank you. So I'm the one busy stressing now and I'm hungry. And I tell Cindy, but babes, there is a stairs where Finesse is. So like Finesse is at the top and then at the bottom. We go upstairs and I'm hungry. The last time I went to stairs, when I saw that stairs, it was when I went to Finesse. So we can just go to stairs and then go continue at Finesse. But Michelle. Saibona ngoko. Really, we Uber to stairs. We get to stairs. We buy food. And Zanasin is drunk. I'm busy being sober. Okay, we buy. And we sit and we eat. We eat. We're trying to call Michelle. Michelle's not picking up the phone. Now we are thinking about, yo, what if something happened to her? But Njani, as she. But anyway, we eat. After a while, she calls us. I'm like, babes, where are you? She's like, no, I'm at the garage next to the boardwalk. If you want, come and get me. The girl has a lever. She has a whole lever around the drumstick. Uti, if you want to. So I just think, doesn't care a damn no matter what. Because we're good people, we go back. And as we leave stairs, whoop, stops the car. In this car, there are cute colored guys also. And Cindy's like, yo, Deirdre, I like that guy. I'm like, hey, boo, so what? Now she's like, Jonga, this I'm bleed. I'm gonna go myself. And she gets to him. She's like, hey, Jay, give me your number. I wanna call you because I like. I'm like, I was Cindy. She's like that. She's like, man, it's gonna take too long because now we're gonna have to make conversation. God, I'm not. I don't want conversation. I want him. And then the poor guy gave his number, sure. And he said, you can call me. And I was shook. I was like, hey, like, girl, now she's bleeding while we're in this situation. But anyway, so we go with the Uber comes and we go back to the garage. I got to see wasting money. I mean, when we get to the garage, here is Michelle. Michelle, get in the car. Michelle wants to be thankful at first. We have to beg her to get into the car. I have to call her. How is call Michelle? So I can start covering. She also thanga. Hi, but we thanga our friend because she was our friend. And then we get into the car and she gives us the silent treatment. The wrong people to give silent treatment because now we are giggling and laughing about what Anders. And I think it was because we were laughing at the Uberman's head. And we Uber back home to Cindy's place. And when we get to Cindy's place, we are drunk. And the bed is this small. It's a single bed for a single person. Slender babes. This small. Me and Cindy, we get into bed. So, like, we're lying on the bed, like, eating our leftover food. Now, Michelle is sitting at the desk, angry, in the middle of the night, playing gospel music. And they called, hi, girl, you are dramatic. You're dramatic. Yes, Molela, you're making a noise. We're trying to sleep. She. And, like, we're laughing about it. And she's making a whole lot of noise. With gospel music while we are drunk and trying to sleep. Now Michelle is making noise, the phone, and we're trying to sleep. Like, we just ignored Hashem. Samyaka, because bingeko lenza, bingeko. So anyway, we slept, we woke up the following day, and she was still angry at us. For like a week, I don't know why she was angry, because she was the one that dumped us about work. And we had to go beg her. But But we ended up being cool with each other again, and we were fine. And my friend, Michelle, I mean, yo, Cindy, my friend Cindy, the one that took the number from the guy, she called the guy, and she and the guy ended up having a thingy. He took her out on dates, and then she went to embarrass me on the dates. Oh, that girl. But I love her so much. It's a story for another day. But at the end, we were all safe and we got home safely. And so cute, guys. Alrighty, but I couldn't understand Jan, a friend yam. Is it Dambe? In a new town, knowing that we're not from there. Yeah, guys, chumze too. But anyway, I love them both to the core. Otherwise, so that was the story for today. I hope you liked it and enjoyed it. Please don't forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe. And thanks for watching, babes. See you next time.